Hi, this project is a demonstration of supermarket billing system. This software is a traditional supermarket billing system with some added functionality. This system is built for fast data processing and bill generation for supermarket customers. The database of this system is a vast collection of product name, price, and other product-specific data. A product when billed is searched from the database and its price is added to the bill based upon the product quantity. The system also contains discounts on various products so that the product is offered at discounted price while billing. This system helps various supermarkets to serve the customer in a fast and efficient manner. Barcode tagging products allows for direct scanning products and their data is added to system automatically. Let's see how the system works. There are two people who will log into the system. One will be the admin, another one will be the cashier. So let's enter the admin ID and the password. Once the admin logins to the system, these are the various options you can access through. Let's see the add cashier module. The cashier ID will be automatically generated by the system itself. These are the various information you must enter. And the password is a 4-digit. This password will be automatically generated by the system and this will be sent to the respective cashier's mail ID. So once the admin clicks onto the submit button, these details will be stored in the database as well as a mail will be sent to the cashier mail ID. Let's see the add products module. Here the product ID is automatically generated by the system. He must specify the product name, quantity and the amount and a short description about this. So let's enter the product name. Quantity and the amount. Amount for per box, pencil box. So and a short description. Once the admin clicks onto the submit button, these details will be submitted. Let's see the view cashier details. Here, admin can view various cashier details about the login time, logout time, as well as the total amount, as well as the date. He can select any of the cashier ID listed over here. So based on this cashier ID, the login time, logout time, and the transaction amount will be displayed on respective date. So let's see the cashier details by date. Here the cashier details will be specified as per the date. So the admin must select the date from and date to. So let's select 9 July. So these are the login time and logout time of respective cashier ID as well as the transaction amount. So let's see the view transaction module. Over here, admin can view various transactions held in the supermarket and he can specify the dates. Based on the dates, these details will be shown over here. Let's see the inventory module. This supermarket system also keeps record of the inventory. So here, the admin can view various products as well as their quantity based on the product ID. So he will specify the product ID and he will click on to the search button. So this is the product name, product ID, as well as the quantity available in the inventory. Let's see the update stock module. Here the admin can specify the product ID. So he will, once he clicks on to the search button, he will view the product name as well as the quantity available in the inventory and he can update the quantity by specifying the quantity of that particular product. He will manually check how many products he had purchased, then according to that he will specify the quantity purchased and he will click on to the update button. Once he clicks on to the update button, these details will be updated in the database itself. So let's see the same product ID. So over here the product is updated. Let's see sales as per the product. So over here the admin can view the sales held in the supermarket of particular product. So he can specify the product ID. Based on the product ID, he will get to know the product name and the quantity sold, as well as the quantity sold, as well as the total amount and the date on which the transaction had been held. And by clicking on to the export to Excel sheet, this details will be exported to the Excel sheet. And here you must specify the name, Excel sheet name. So once he clicks on to the save button, these details will be exported to the Excel sheet, and admin can take a print of this and can use this data for various purposes. Let's see the sales as per day. Here the admin will specify the date from and to, and the sales happen between these dates will be shown over here. So let's click on to this date. Let's select this date and begin July. Once I click on to the search button, these are the transaction held on particular date and the total amount and the product name and the quantity and the total amount the transaction had been done. So once he clicks on to the export to Excel, these details will be exported to the Excel sheet, and admin can use these details for various purposes. This is how the admin module works. Let's see the cashier module. Let's see the various options the cashier can access. So cashier must enter the cashier ID and the password. So let's enter the cashier ID and the password. This password will be sent to the respective cashier email ID. So you will use the ID and the password in order to log into the system. So once the cashier logins to the system, these are the options he can access through. Let's see the bill module. The bill number will be generated by the system itself. Also, you must specify the product ID. So this is out of stock, so let's enter another product ID. This product ID will be scanned by the cashier. So the respective details will be shown about that product. The product name, price and the quantity will be automatically shown. If the cashier wants to increase the quantity, so he can do so by entering the quantity number, as well as if any discount is provided for particular product, so he can specify the discount in percentage. So once he enters the percentage, once he clicks on to the add button, the discount will be automatically calculated by the system itself, and it will be shown over here and it will be stored in the database itself. So if I enter another product ID, so these details will be shown over here. Once I click on to the add button, this details will be shown over here and will be added to the database. So once I click on to the calculate total amount, the total amount will be calculated and will be displayed to the cashier, respective cashier. So once he clicks on to the export to Excel, this details will be exported to the Excel sheet, and he can take a print about this bill. So let's see the product information. Here the cashier can view various product details by specifying the product ID. So let's enter the product ID. So once I click on to the search button, so the product ID will be displayed and the respective details, whatever the details is, product name, quantity available in the inventory, as well as the amount of particular product, as well as the description. This is how the supermarket billing system works. Thank you.